Praise the Lord, friends. Welcome back to Spiritual Morsels. Palm Sunday is here, and everywhere people are going to celebrate the triumphal entry of Jesus into Jerusalem. We read about this incident in all four Gospels. People came out in large numbers waving palm branches and spreading their coats on the floor on the road for Jesus to walk. But today, I want to focus on the mode of transport that Jesus used to go to Jerusalem, to travel to Jerusalem. We read about it in the Gospel of Luke chapter 19, verse 30. It was a donkey, the colt of a donkey. The prophet Zechariah looked into the future and he saw this incident happening, and he proclaimed, he said like this in Zechariah chapter 9, verse 9. O daughter of Zion, shout, O daughter of Jerusalem, behold, your king is coming to you. He is just and having salvation, lowly and riding on a donkey, a colt, a foal of a donkey. In Luke chapter 19, verse 30, we see something very special about this donkey. No one had ever ridden it. It was an untouched animal brought up with great care by its owners. But when the disciples go there and untie it, we see the owners of the animal, they asking them, hey, what are you guys up to? What are you doing? And the disciples say in verse 34, they say, the Lord needs it. And what caught my attention here was that was the end of the argument. That was the end of the conversation. That's it. If the Lord needs it, okay, fine. No questions asked. You can take it. My dear friends, I just want to pause here. You know, in our lives, there are so many things that we take care, we bring it up with great care. Our career, our money, our children, our future. Now suppose if we happen to hear these words, the Lord needs it, just like the owners of the donkey heard from the disciples, what will be our response? What will we do? Will we happily give it to the Lord like the owners of the donkey, or will we try to argue and reason with him? And then in verse 35, we see that the disciples, they bring the donkey to Jesus. They put their coats on the donkey and they put Jesus on the donkey. And as they move further, the people came and they spread their coats on the road. And in the book of John, in the Gospel of John chapter 12, we see that people came in large groups waving palm branches, all for Jesus. Now, for the Jews, spreading coats on the road was a sign of acknowledgement of a king. We see this in the book of 2 Kings chapter 9, where they spread their coats on the road when they crown Jehu as king, and they declare him as king and make him walk on their coats. So this was a gesture of acknowledging the person as their king. And then in the episode 39 of Spiritual Morsels, I was speaking about the festival of booths, or the feast of Sukkot, where I had explained that the waving of palm branches was an expression of joy and gratitude in the presence of the Lord. Now, as the people were doing all these things to honor Jesus, who was actually enjoying all this? The donkey. The disciples put their coats on the donkey. They did it for Jesus, but they actually put it on the donkey. The people were spreading their expensive coats on the road for Jesus, but it was the donkey who was in fact stamping over all these expensive coats and enjoying. He was being treated like a prince. In verse 45, Jesus enters the temple in Jerusalem. Now, when Jesus enters the temple, the donkey is waiting outside at the temple gate. Now, this is my imagination. As he is waiting there at the gate, he sees a cloth merchant sitting there beside the street and arranging all his clothes in a beautiful way for display, for selling his clothes. The donkey slowly walks over to the cloth merchant and he puts one leg on one of those expensive clothes. What do you think would have happened? The merchant got furious, he hit the donkey and he chased it away. Later, this poor donkey, as he was running away, he saw a group of people standing there holding palm branches and talking in a group, in a circle. So he goes to them, expecting them to wave the palm branches at him. But again, they chase him away. This poor animal is completely baffled. He's wondering, what's wrong with all these people? Just a few minutes back, these guys waved their branches at me. These guys spread their expensive clothes expensive coats on the floor for me to walk. And now they act as if they don't recognize me. What's wrong with these people? Dear donkey, the treatment of honor you received is not because of who you are, but it was only because of the one who was riding on your back. Dear friends, many times when we experience unmerited favor in our lives, when we experience undeserved honor, when we experience unexpected success and blessings and all the good things in our lives, we must never forget that it is not because of who we are, but it is because of the one who is riding on us, because of the one who is living inside of us. The moment we start taking pride in our own strength, our own wisdom, and our smartness, that would be the beginning of our downfall. James chapter 4 verse 6 says, God resists the proud, but he gives grace to the humble. If any of us have reached a point in our life where we are trying to move forward, but we are facing some kind of resistance, it is good if we can take a moment and examine ourselves to see, to check if the resistance is coming from God. I pray in the coming days that may God help each one of us to remain humble, acknowledging the fact that every blessing, every good thing that we experience in our lives is not because of who we are, but only because of Jesus. Amen. God bless you.